around here. Now, I would like to have thought that I should have been a wise man. I guess the donkey will suffice. This week I was reading a quote by J.J. Abrams. He's the director of the new Star Wars film. And in that quote he stated this, "Movies speak to a human desire, possible need, to congregate and experience stories communally. They are experiences which allow us to feel connectivity." When I read that quote, I immediately thought of our weekly worship gatherings and how in corporate worship we are connected. We're connected to each other, and we're connected to God, and that the beauty of this Advent season is the retelling and the re-experiencing together the ancient stories that are vital to our faith. Today's the fourth Sunday of Advent. We spent this Advent season alongside the activities of decorating and shopping and partying, preparing internally, spiritually, to ensure a correct mindset and a correct heart for the Christmas season. As a review, we started back on week one with an emphasis on hope, and we acknowledged that while sometimes our nights are silent, all is not always calm. We were reminded of the promise of Emmanuel, that during times of hopelessness, God is with us, bringing the hope of new birth and new beginnings found in Christ. And this was our takeaway from week one, that in this season of gift-giving, that it's our responsibility to receive the gift of hope. And we prayed together that we would move the reality of the message of Christmas from here, from a head knowledge, to here, a heartfelt reality. And I pray that you have found that reality. And if not, it certainly isn't too late. The following week was the Sunday of Peace. Valerie challenged us to look beyond the external realities, beyond all of the noise, and to look within, and to embrace peace. Our takeaway that week was a challenge that as we receive the peace of Christ, we are also to be active, to be people of peace, and to bring peace to others. Last week was the Sunday of Joy. We gave thanks that joy arrives when divinity dances within us. And we celebrated the fact that joy is all around us, and joy is within us. And I offered that if joy is truly our aim, if joy is an end result, then it deserves our very close attention. That we need more than a season, a time frame of glad tidings. That we must seek and we must choose joy all year long. And we need a community of friends right beside us, reminding us every day that joy is possible. We need friends who will bring the joy. And we ended last week choosing joy and together dancing the snowman shuffle. And if you were not here, please go to the St. Mark's Facebook page and watch the video. It will bring you a little bit of joy, I promise. Today is the Advent Sunday of love. Can everybody say love?
Love
is how we transform the message of Christmas. Love is how we transform hope, peace, and joy into a present-day reality. Now, I maintain that the word love is very much overused. Think about how we use it. I say I love you. I love winter. I love Christmas lights. I love pizza. And on Instagram, we click a heart to say that we love that picture, or we add a string of hearts on Facebook to show that I really love what you just posted. With this overuse, it seems that the word love has become actually just a stronger expression of like. Something that I like, something I really, really, really like, then I love it. I hope that together the stories and the message of Advent can serve us well in reminding that love isn't just another expression of something that I really, really like. True love is found in the Christmas story, and true love is demonstrative. Love is not just an expression, an easy statement. Love requires a response. J. John 3:16 states, "For God so loved the world that he gave his son." John 15:13, "Greater love has no one than this, than to lay one's life down for one's friends." In Galatians 4, "When the time was fully come, God sent his son, born among us of a woman, so that he might redeem us and set us free to experience our rightful heritage." Love is much more than a simple expression. And as Christ followers, we are not relieved of the responsibilities that come with love by simply saying an easy statement. Love for us requires a response. Love is love when love is put into action. Luke 19:10, "For the Son of Man came to find and to restore the lost." This is the message of love found in Jesus. To save us not just from our naughty list, but from our sad list, our lonely list, the broken heart and the broken dream list. To save us from "I am good enough on my own" list. Whatever list you are on, because of love, because of Christ, God has pursued you to express love to you through transformation and restoration. The coming of the Christ child reminds us constantly that we are pursued. We are pursued with a love that can change us. This is the heart of the Christmas story, a radical expression of God's love for us. 1 John 4:9. "This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him." God leaned into humanity and offered love. Mary, Joseph, the shepherds, the wise men, each of them said yes to the message of love that the angels proclaimed. The same message of good news of love is offered to us today by our God of self-giving love. Now, whether you feel it, whether you believe it, you are love. Nothing you can do can cause God to love you less. You can't earn it. You can't create it, buy it, wrap it. You accept it. So I invite you, dear, in this season to stop running, to stop resisting, and to say yes to ultimate love. Embrace the hope, peace, joy, and love expressed through a baby in a manger. And allow God to change you from the inside out. So this morning I ask you a personal question. Are there areas of your life where love is not having the final say? Are there areas in your life where love is not having the final say? I ask that God will bring those to your mind right now. Think of those areas. And as you do, whether it's right now, at the end of this service, or sometime this week, invite God into those areas where love is not having the final say. Invite God to send transforming love into that place. This Christmas message of love is powerful. When we embrace God's self-giving love, it changes us. And then we have the responsibility to love through action. I want to make this practical. I want to really bring it home. Can you hear me through these few sentences? Our ultimate expression of Christmas love is not to say Merry Christmas. We cannot regulate our responsibility to share such a powerful love by easily setting up a manger scene in our home, office, or city square. And in doing that, think we've accomplished our mission of sharing Christ's love. It's not enough to sit here in a worship service to sing some carols and go home. It's not enough to trade gifts and cards. And it's definitely not enough to make easy proclamations about keeping Christ in Christmas. This should not, must not be the extent to which we celebrate the birth of Jesus. We celebrate and share Christmas love by living like Jesus, by giving like Jesus, by serving, rolling our sleeves up, getting dirty, and sacrificing like Jesus. We truly proclaim the Christmas message of love by loving like Jesus. Christmas is all about embracing God's love, speaking God's love, sharing God's love, and above all, demonstrating God's love. So back to my first point. Love isn't simply a stronger expression of light. Love is meant to be lived out. We can extend Christmas love every time we encourage someone to embrace the hope, the peace, and joy of God through our words and our actions. This is how we can celebrate Christmas during this short season and all year long. God offered love through the gift of the Christ child, the gift of Christmas. And in the Christmas story, Joseph said yes. Mary said yes. And now it is our time to say yes to love. And when we say yes to love, it is through that miracle of answering yes that we are changed. We are transformed. And in doing so, our world is transformed as we leave being people who love. Let us pray. Our God, thank you for your all-giving love. Thank you for pursuing us, for demonstrating your love for us through the birth of Jesus. Advent gives us space. Advent gives us time to prepare before we jump headfirst into Christmas. And I ask this morning that you will call our hearts to your attention. May Christmas love move from our heads to our heart, from an idea to a personal reality. May we receive, unwrap, and respond to your great gift, the ultimate love expressed in the birth and life of Jesus Christ. And whether here or online, may each person accept this message of Christ and say yes. Yes to the gift of love, and yes to God's dream that is taking birth in their life. And God, by the mysterious working of your Spirit, show each of us places in our lives where love is not having the final say, and speak love into those areas. And instead of all the holiday hustle, the bustle and stress, help us, strengthen us, empower us to trade all of that in and embrace, experience, and share love one more time, one more day. Amen.
And as we continue to worship, let us stand.
Because you died and rose again.
Today's message is that we allow love to be much more than a statement, and that we take seriously our responsibility to share love with others. Now, actions don't always have to be extravagant or even difficult. Love can be expressed simply, particularly during this ramped-up intensity of the holidays, in the simplest of ways, through a smile. When you smile, even when you don't feel like it, you're opening the pathway to your heart. And once that pathway is opened, the next smile comes easier. That's why smiles are contagious and instantly connect people one to another. Last year in this season, I gave an assignment, and I think it's worth repeating this year. So right now, I ask you to smile. Smile with me, and I invite you to look at the person beside you, look at them in the eye, and smile. I know it's awkward, I know it's uncomfortable, I know it's weird, but smile. And as you go, don't let this season pass without saying to those in your life, I love you. But please, also, don't let this season pass without putting those words into action, sharing your love and sharing your smile beyond these doors.